Lupin Pharmaceuticals in association with Higher Secondary Principals Forum.
Yes, hi students. I'm Mr. Linson Thomas, teacher from St. Francis Xavier's High Secondary School, Siolim. Today we will discuss the second chapter of your syllabus in accountancy. I hope you have learned the first chapter before going through this video. What did you learn in the first chapter? Do you remember? Yes. You learned basic information on partnership, a lot of in theory on partnership. You learned how to prepare a profit and loss appropriation account. You solved many problems. You also learned different methods of preparing the capital accounts of partners, the fluctuating capital method, fixed capital method, and so on. Very good. Now, after learning the basic information on partnership, let us go a little more in detail. Can you tell me what is a partnership? In short, very brief, even if you say one word about partnership, that would be sufficient. What is that one word with which you can describe a partnership? Partnership is an agreement. Partnership is an agreement. Can one person make an agreement with himself? No. A person can make a decision alone by himself. But to make an agreement, to make a contract, he needs another person. That is why in a partnership firm, there will be more than two persons. So two or more persons will be there as owners of a partnership firm. And what is the maximum number of people who can be in a partnership firm? Yes, it is 50. 50, it can go up to 50 according to the present acts in our country. Now, these two or more persons, they come together to make an agreement. Okay, what are they agreeing for? What are they agreeing for? They are agreeing to do a business. So, this agreement is to do a business. So, partnership is mainly to do a business. If two or more people come together and think about doing some charitable work, it will not be considered as a partnership firm, because partnership is formed to do a business. And when people do business, they make profits or losses. So these profits and losses are to be shared among the partners. So that is another feature of partnership firm. Profits and losses are shared among the partners. Okay, so the partnership firm is an agreement. Partnership is an agreement to do a business, the profit and losses of which are shared by all the partners. And the business is carried on by all or any one of them acting for all. So, partnership business is carried on by one of them, or it can be carried on by all of them. Now, let us ask a question. Can there be any change in this agreement at any point of time? If there is any change in the partnership agreement, that is what we mean by reconstitution of partnership firm. So today's class, what I am going to discuss in detail with you is about reconstitution of a partnership firm. So the change in the agreement made by the partners amounts to reconstitution of a partnership firm. What are the different situations a partnership firm is reconstituted? A partnership firm is reconstituted when there is an admission of a partner. When a new partner is admitted, when there is retirement or death of a partner, when partner becomes insolvent, and lastly, when there is a change in the profit and loss sharing ratio. So, partnership is an agreement. Whenever there is an change in the agreement among the partners, whatever deed they have made, that is called a reconstitution. And one of the situations where a partnership is reconstituted is when a new partner is admitted. So we are going to discuss the accounting of admission of a new partner. Now, what are the reasons for admitting a new partner? A new partner may be admitted in order to acquire additional capital for the firm. It may be for acquiring additional capital, or it may be for getting managerial help. So there are basically two requirements for admitting a new partner. Maybe to get additional capital, the firm wants to expand its business, purchase new assets, or invest in building, or invest in technology. So they want additional capital. So they may require that from another person who can invest in their business. So in order to get additional capital, a partner may be admitted, or also for managerial help, for technical help. Okay, a new partner is admitted. Now, according to the Indian Partnership Act 1932, unless it is otherwise provided in the partnership deed, a new partner can be admitted only when all the existing partners unanimously agree for it. So all the partners must agree, they must agree to admit a new partner. It's very, very important. A new partner can be admitted only when all the existing partners unanimously agree for it, unless otherwise mentioned in the partnership deed. Now, when a partner is admitted, he gets two rights. What are those two rights? He can get a right to the assets of the business. He becomes a part owner of the business. So he becomes a part owner of the machinery, of the land, of the finances, of all the assets of the business. At the same time, he also gets another right, a right to share the profits of the business. So here it is very important to know the new partner can share the future profits of the business. If there were any existing profits of the previous period, or if there were some reserves of the previous period, accumulated surplus of the previous period, a new partner will not get any share in that. He will get an access to future profits of the business. If you look at the slide, you will get the chapter at a glance. In this chapter, we will be learning the calculation of new profit and loss sharing ratio. We will also be learning the sacrifice ratio. We will learn how to value goodwill, how to adjust goodwill on the admission of a new partner. We will learn how to revalue assets and reassess liabilities of the business to find the new values and compare whether there is any increase in the values and decrease in the values. We will learn how to distribute accumulated profits or reserves of the business. And we will learn how to adjust partners' capital accounts. So these are the adjustments that we are going to learn in this chapter. The very first adjustment that you are going to learn is the calculation of new profit and loss sharing ratio. When a new partner is admitted, when a new partner, now this term new partner refers to the newly admitted partner. Okay, new partner. We may also use the term old partners. Old partners refers to the existing partners. Existing partners. So, when a partner is admitted, he becomes the new partner in the existing firm. There will be a change in the profit and loss sharing ratio. How do we calculate the change in the profit and loss sharing ratio? You will be learning three methods to calculate the profit and loss sharing ratio: method 1, method 2, and method 3. There will be three methods, and these methods refer to the type of information available to you, the type of information given in your question paper. Okay, the method 1 is followed when old partners' share of profits and losses and share of the new partner are given in the question. So if you are given the old partner's share of profit and losses, we call it old ratio. Old ratio and share of the new partner are given. So here what we have to do is we have to follow these steps. We will first find out the balance of profits. Then we will divide the balance of profits in the old ratio among the old partners. Then we will be finding the new profit and loss sharing ratio. Let us see how to solve a problem using this method. Anil and Vishal are partners sharing profits and losses in the ratio of 3:2. So 3:2 is the ratio of Anil and Vishal. This is what we mean by the old ratio. Okay, you have to note it down. They admitted Sumit as a new partner for 1/5 share. So the share of Sumit is the new partner, for 1/5 is the share of new partner in the future profits of the firm. Calculate new profit sharing ratio of Anil, Vishal and Sumit. So this is the question given to you. The very first thing that you need to do is to identify what are the information given to you. Now in this question, you are given the old ratio of Anil and Vishal. What is the old ratio? Old ratio is given here, 3:2. So you will note it down, 3:2. This is the old ratio. And what is the share of the new partner, Sumit? It's given in the question, 1/5. So Sumit is getting 1/5 share. So you will note this down. So when these two information are given, you are going to follow the first method. What is the first method? If 1/5 share is given to the new partner, what would be the balance of profit? For example, suppose if we divide the entire profits into 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5 blocks. Out of this, one block of profit is given to the new partner. So how many blocks will remain? There will be 4 out of 5 remaining. So you will calculate the balance of profit using this formula, 1 minus share of the new partner. So this will mean 1 minus 1/5, which we calculated 4/5. Okay, you can also calculate it by finding the LCM, and you can calculate it 1 minus 1/5. Or a shortcut method that you can remember is, from the denominator, from 5, if you minus the numerator, you get the new numerator. What is the denominator here? 5. What is the numerator? 1. So 5 minus 1, you will get the numerator 4. So 4/5 is the balance of profit. Okay, now let us divide this balance of profit among the old partners in their old ratio. So what would be the new share of Anil? The new share of Anil will be balance of profit 4/5 multiplied by old share of Anil. The old ratio is given here, 3:2. Old share of Anil will be 3/total, 3+2, that is 5. So we will multiply it by 3/5. Now 4 multiplied by 3, you will get 12/5 multiplied by 5, you will get 25. So 12/25 is the new share of Anil. Similarly, we can calculate the new share of Vishal. The balance of profit, we are considering the same, 4/5 multiplied by the share of Vishal in the old firm. In the old form, we shall share verse 2 upon 5. So you will multiply by 2 upon 5. Now 4 multiplied by 2, you will get 8. 5 multiplied by 5, you get 25. So 8 upon 25 is the share of Vishal in the new form. So we calculate the share of Anil, we calculated the share of Vishal. Share of Sumir is given to us. So 12 upon 25, 8 upon 25, and 1 upon 5 is the share of Sumir that's given to us. Now, how do we write it as a ratio? The new profit and loss sharing ratio will be 12 upon 25 is to 8 upon 25 is to 1 upon 5. Here you will notice the denominator is 25 for the first proportion. The second one also it is 25, whereas the third one it is 5. So you cannot make it like a ratio. So what you must do? You must convert this 5 also into 25 by multiplying by 5. Now when you multiply the denominator, you should also multiply the numerator. So now it becomes better. So the new ratio will be 12 is to 8 is to 5. So 12 is to 8 is to 5 is the new profit sharing ratio. So this is how we calculate the new profit sharing ratio when we are given basically just two information, that is old ratio and share of new partner. So when these two information are given, we will follow these steps, finding the balance profit and dividing the balance profit in the old ratio. Then we get the new profit sharing ratio. Now here, if you notice, in this method we assumed that the new partner acquired his share from the old partners in their old ratio. That's why we divided the balance profit in the old ratio. Okay, what happens if this is not the case? So let us see. Look at this question. Akshay and Joseph are partners sharing profits and losses in the ratio of 3:2. They admit Dinesh as a new partner for 1/5 share in the future profits of the firm, which he gets equally from Akshay and Joseph. Calculate new profit sharing ratio of Akshay, Joseph and Dinesh. The very first thing that you should do is observe what are the information given here. What are the information given? You will notice that you are given the ratio of old partners. Who are the old partners? Akshay and Joseph. Akshay and Joseph are sharing profits and losses in the ratio of 3:2. So 3 upon 5 and 2 upon 5. This is the information given and this is the old ratio. Okay, when old ratio is given, very good. What else is given? You are given, they admit Dinesh as a new partner for 1/5 share in the future profits. So you are given share of the new partner. These two information were given in the previous question also. Besides these two, is there anything else given here? Yes, let us continue to read the problem, which he gets equally from Akshay and Joseph. So here there is a third information given, which is how the old partners have sacrificed, how the old partners have given out their share to the new partner. So it is given, the new partner is acquiring, getting equally from Akshay and Joseph. What does it mean? It means if Akshay gave one share, how much Joseph gave? Joseph also gave one share. So both the partners have contributed equally, means their contribution towards the new partner is in the ratio of 1:1. So this is what we mean by sacrifice ratio. Sacrifice ratio. Okay, what is sacrifice ratio? It is nothing but the ratio in which old partners sacrifice, give out their share to the new partner. So here in this question, it is given as equal. That means it is given as 1:1. So now let us write all the information given to us in the question. We are given the old share of Akshay and Joseph. So what is the old ratio? That is 3:2. This is given, that we have noted. Then we are given the share of the new partner. What's the share of the new partner? Dinesh has 1/5. So share of Dinesh is 1/5. Then besides this, we are also given the sacrifice ratio of Akshay and Joseph, which is 1:1. How 1:1? It is mentioned equally. If Akshay gives one share, Joseph also gave one share. Okay, so we are given old ratio, we are given share of the new partner, we are given sacrifice ratio. So this is the second method. When these three information are given, we cannot find the balance profit and divide it as we did in the previous problem. So how are we going to find out? We will find out the actual sacrifice of the old partners. What does it mean? It is given that old partners sacrifice equally, 1:1. But how much they sacrificed is not mentioned. So we will find out the actual sacrifice of the old partners using this formula. What is the share of the new partner? Multiply it in the sacrifice ratio. So then we will get the actual sacrifice. This actual sacrifice, if we minus from the old share minus actual sacrifice, we are going to get the new share of the old partners. So let us see how to calculate it. The old ratio is 3:2, share of new partner is 1/5, sacrifice ratio is 1:1. So what is the actual sacrifice of Akshay? That will be equal to share of new partner, which is 1/5, multiplied by share of sacrifice. Okay, sacrifice of partner is 1/2. So partner sacrifices half. That means 1 multiplied by 1 is 1. 5 multiplied by 2 is 10. So 1/10 is the actual sacrifice of Akshay. Now, how do we find the new share of Akshay? New share of Akshay is calculated using this formula. That is equal to old share. Old share is 3/5 minus the actual sacrifice, 1/5. So how do we minus it? We have to keep the denominators the same. We can find the LCM and calculate it. Okay, or when we do the denominator same, simple method, you have to multiply 5 by 2. So when you multiply 5 by 2, you will multiply 3 also by 2. So you will get 6/10 minus 1/10. You will get the new share of Akshay, 5/10. So 5/10 is the new share of Akshay. This is how we calculate. We calculated his actual sacrifice. We knew that he sacrificed equally, but how much is that equal, we could not make out. Okay, so we calculated the actual sacrifice, and that actual sacrifice we deducted from the old share. So we got the new share. Similarly, what will be the actual sacrifice of Joseph? We will apply the formula. Share of the new partner is 1/5 multiplied by sacrifice ratio. What is the sacrifice of second partner Joseph? Again, his sacrifice is 1/2. Okay, how do we get this 2? 1+1. So 1:1 means 1/2:1/2. So his share of sacrifice is 1/2, which comes again 1/10. So what will be the new share? His old share, 2/5 minus 1/10. So we will multiply this by 2:2. So this will be 4/10 minus 1/10. So this will be 3/10. So we got the share of Joseph in the new form. Share of Akshay is 5/10 and share of Joseph is 3/10. Share of the new partner Dinesh is already given to us. Okay, it is 1/5. So we can make the ratio now. 5/10, then 3/10 and 1/5. How do we write it like a ratio? Yes, we will write 5/10 is to 3 upon 10 is to 1 upon 5. Okay, so 5, 1 upon 5, here the denominator 5 is not matching with the other denominator. So we will convert it by multiplying by 2. Now when we multiply the denominator, we will also multiply the numerator. Okay, so we are getting the final ratio 5 is to 3 is to 2. This is the profit sharing ratio of the partners. Now here it would be interesting to note that a ratio should be expressed in the shortest way possible. For example, suppose you got a ratio like this 50 is to 30 is to 20. You cannot keep it as the final ratio, you have to make it short. How can you make short? Easily you can divide, remove 110 from each figure. So you will be able to write 5 is to 3 is to 2. This is the shortest way possible for expressing this particular ratio. So please remember, a ratio should be always expressed in the shortest way possible. You should be able to divide all the items, all the numbers by a common number and make it minimum. Okay, make it minimum. So you should be able to express the ratio in the shortest way possible. Now let us look at the next method. In the second method, we are given the sacrifice ratio and we found out the actual sacrifice. What happens if actual sacrifice is directly given to you? If actual sacrifice is given, it's very easy. Okay, that is the easiest method. You have to directly less from the old share of the old partners. So let us explore the method 3. Here, Anshu and Nithu are partners sharing profits in the ratio of 3 is to 2. They admitted Razia as a new partner for 3 upon 10th share, which she acquired 2 upon 10 from Anshu and 1 upon 10 from Nithu. Calculate new profit and loss sharing ratio of Anshu, Nithu and Razia. Okay. So let us find the new ratio. The very first thing you will find, what are the information given. Here Anshu and Nithu are partners sharing profits in the ratio of 3 is to 2. This is the old ratio. So old ratio is given. They admitted Razia as a new partner for 3 upon 10th share. So this is the share of the new partner, 3 upon 10, which she acquired 2 upon 10th from Anshu. So Anshu is giving 2 upon 10th and Nithu is giving 1 upon 10th. So these are the actual sacrifices. Actual sacrifice of Anshu and actual sacrifice of Nithu are given to us. So here sacrifice ratio is not known or it is not given, but instead we are given the actual sacrifice of the partners. So how do we calculate the new profit sharing ratio? So let us write what are the information given. Old ratio of Anshu and Nithu, that is 3 is to 2. Okay, we are given the share of the new partner 3 upon 10. And we are given actual sacrifice directly. Actual sacrifice of Anshu is 2 upon 10. And actual sacrifice of Nithu is 1 upon 10. So these are the information given to us. Let us find out the new profit sharing ratio. How do we find the new profit sharing ratio? When actual sacrifice is given, we have to just minus actual sacrifice from the old share. So old share minus actual sacrifice, that will be the formula you will be applying here. So let us find the new share of Anshu. New share of Anshu will be 3 upon 5, this is the old share, minus 3 upon 10. So here we will keep the denominators equal. Okay, so this will become 6 upon 10 minus 3 upon 10. So you will get 3 upon, actual sacrifice of Anshu is 2. Okay, so we are going to get 4 upon 10. This is 2. So 4 upon 10. Now, what about the new share of Nitu? New share of Nitu, old share is 2 upon 5 minus 1 upon 10. We will convert it by multiplying by 2. So we will get 4 upon 10 minus 1 upon 10. So this will be equal to 3 upon 10. So we got the new share of the old partner Anshu. We got the new share of Nitu, and the share of Rasiya is already given. So we will write the new profit and loss sharing ratio. How do we write it? We are given 4 upon 10, 3 upon 10, and 3 upon 10. So the new ratio will be 4 upon 10 is to 3 upon 10 is to 3 upon 10. So are these figures the shortest figures? Yes, these are the shortest way possible. So we will write 4 is to 3 is to 3, and the answer is correct. So this is how we calculate the new profit sharing ratio in the method 3. So students, we learned 3 methods. Now how do you identify which method is given in the question paper? It depends upon the information given to you in the question paper. Okay, according to the information given, you are finalizing the method. In the method 1, 2, 3, old ratio will be given. So, looking at the old ratio, you may not be able to identify which method is to be followed. Old ratio is available in all the 3 methods. What about the share of new partner? Share of new partner also may be given in the first method and second method and third method. It is compulsorily given in the first method and second method, but may or may not be given in the method 3. In method 3, actual sacrifice is given. So when you combine all the actual sacrifices, you will be able to get the total sacrifice, which is equal to the new partner's share. Now, sacrifice ratio, is it given in the first method? No, it is not given. Okay, this is not given in the first method. It is given only in the second method. It is not given in the third method. So, looking at the sacrifice ratio, you will be very easily identifying the method. Second method, sacrificing ratio is the most important point to look at. If sacrifice ratio is given, it could be mostly second method. Why did I say it could be? Because in the third method, both can be given. Sacrifice ratio can be given sometimes, and also the actual sacrifice is given. Now, actual sacrifice, if it is given, it is the third method. Without fail, you can identify it as the third method. So, actual sacrifice is the most important element to look at if you want to take up the method 3. So, this is how you will be identifying the method, how to solve a problem, how to find the new partner profit and loss sharing ratio. From the given question, you will identify according to the information given to you. Now, I mentioned earlier about the sacrifice ratio. Sacrifice ratio is nothing but the ratio in which old partners agree to give out their share, sacrifice their share towards the new partner. Okay, the new partner is able to enjoy profits of the future business. In what ratio he will be enjoying that future profits? In the ratio of profits given to him by the old partners. So, in what proportion the old partners are sacrificing their share to the new partner is what we mean by sacrifice ratio. How do we calculate the sacrifice ratio? We have to find the old share of profit and minus the new share of profit. Okay, for example, suppose there are two partners, A and B, and they were sharing profits and losses in the ratio of, say, 7:3. Now, they admitted a new partner, so the new partnership firm became ABC partnership firm, and in the new partnership firm, the share is coming to 4:2:4. 4:2:4. So you are given the old ratio. You are also given the new ratio. How do we find what is the sacrifice of partner A? Sacrifice of A. What is the sacrifice of A? We will take his old share, that is 7/10, minus what is his new share now? 4/10. So from this, when you minus 7 minus 4, you will get a 3, and 10 is the common denominator. So 3/10 is the sacrifice of A. What about the sacrifice of partner B? We will follow the same formula. His old share is 3/10 minus the new share of partner B is 2/10. So we will minus 2/10. So we will get 1/10. So what is the sacrifice ratio? Sacrifice ratio of A and B, that is 3/10:1/10, which will mean 3:1. So this is how we calculate the sacrifice ratio of the old partners. Please remember, only the old partners are sacrificing. So only the old partners will have a sacrifice ratio. Don't take the new partner and find out his sacrifice. He is a new partner. He is the benefiting partner. He benefits because he acquires shares from the old partners. So this is how we calculate the sacrifice ratio of the partners. So in this lesson, we learned how to calculate the new profit and loss sharing ratio using three methods. According to the information given, we have to identify the method. Okay, if it is the first method, you will get only old ratio and share of the new partner. If it is second method, you will get the sacrifice ratio. And if it is the third method, you will get the actual sacrifice. So according to the information given, you will find out the method to be applied, and you will choose the method and prepare, find out the new profit and loss sharing ratio. You also learned how to calculate the sacrifice ratio. What is sacrifice ratio? It is nothing but old share minus new share. Okay, thank you, students.
Prudent Scholars, powered by Lupin Pharmaceuticals.